that analysis are as follows. The recommended building capacity of Aldridge is 1,103. The recommended building capacity of Gorton is 1,082. The current enrollment unweighted of Aldridge is 517 students. This represents 46.86% of the recommended building capacity at Aldridge. The current enrollment unweighted of Gorton is 411 students. This represents 38% of the recommended building capacity at Gorton.
No, I don't think we do.
The percent weighted capacity at present based on the recommended building capacity at Aldridge is 54.84%. The percent weighted capacity at present based on the recommended building capacity at Gorton is 42.79%. Following this, the junior high scenarios were presented. If Aldridge closed and half the population of Aldridge went to Gorton, the other half would go to Windman, Gorton's population would be 669 students with a recommended building capacity of 1082. This equals 61.8% capacity. If Gorton closed and half the population of Gorton went to Aldridge, the other half would go to Windman, Aldridge's population would be 721.5 with a recommended building capacity of 1,103. This equals 65.4% capacity.
When I find myself in times of trouble, Mother Mary comes to me, speaking words of wisdom, let it be. And in my hour of darkness, she is standing right in front of me, speaking words of wisdom, let it be. Let it be, let it be. Hearted people living in the world agree there will be an answer, let it be. For though they may be parted, there is still a chance that they will see.
Yes, it does not preclude us technically from going to a middle school model. It certainly puts that possibility off for several years. And again, my concern is with Common Core and how it was designed, and I'll preface it by saying I'm not an educator, but I can learn. And the way Common Core was designed was to be delivered in the middle school model. I think the students get math and science delivered to them much more effectively than we're currently delivering it to them. I think the space is there. I think by doing that, it frees up room in the elementaries. We have an elementary that borders an expanded airport that we may want to look at doing something. And the last thing I will submit to you that it's a little easier to close an elementary school than a junior high because of the community you affect, the size of the community you affect. But again, I'll go back to my original point here. I think closing Gorton, there's no question that right now, as currently constituted, the schools are vastly underpopulated. But that's in the current static model. So if we close one and we stick to it, then we're closing one and we're going to go with two junior high schools. That middle school decision, I think, is just put off until 6 or 7 years, and we're going to have a bunch of kids going through the system, especially sixth graders, that, in my opinion, are shortchanged curriculum-wise because of the decision that we made.
bottom line, as you can see, was if Aldrich Junior High School was closed, the savings would be $1,098,963. If the Gorton Junior High School option was chosen and that was chosen or selected to close, the savings would be $1,007,562.
Then why not explore this a little bit further? Why not just take a little more time and truly study the impact of closing the school? I'm not saying that we shouldn't close the school. I'm not saying that we don't have to close the school. I'm just asking that we explore this option a little further and also explore the other options that we have not. And as far as last year, I served on the committee as well, and nothing happened. We dissolved in January. We put everything on the table. We walked away from it. Okay, we picked it up this past December, and I have to say, this has moved very quickly, and the parent committee has not met since January 2nd. Today's the first time. The long-term planning subcommittee has not met at all until today. And the short-term committee made a determination last week to go to the school committee without speaking, you know, without, you know, calling the...
It ain't about how fast I get there.
Money that we're going to save, should we close Gorton, is this money going to be applied to technology and to a better classroom structure for the kids? Where is this money going to be applied? Where was the money applied for the last consolidation as well?
Mr. Ferrucci, would you like to explain what you want to talk?
It's interesting with regards to where is the money going to be applied. From the perspective of this, our school budgets over the last few years have relied on surplus from the prior year, and we were fortunate. We've been fortunate because we haven't had to wrestle with what do we need to eliminate to get to a balanced budget. And I think that's really the critical issue that's getting lost in the fiscal conversation that's going on. We're faced with $2.8 million of surplus this year carrying our school budget forward. Last spring, we were talking about what needed to be cut. And as we went into the summer, we went in with the balanced budget on the backs of cutting things. And we were fortunate enough to bring back and maintain what we have. Because of that surplus. That surplus will go away, I promise you. It's not going to be available for next year because we were fortunate last year that our school busing didn't have to pay $400 a day to first student. Well, at the beginning of this school year, we did. We saved $1 million last year by not having new buses on the road and utilizing our old buses. If you look around, we're driving new buses, which is all the kids are impacted, and it will, in fact, utilize that surplus.
Unsinkable ships sink, unbreakable walls break. Sometimes the things you think never happen. Happened just like that. Unbendable steel bends. If the fury of the wind is unstoppable, I've learned to never underestimate the impossible.